Hi, my name is Maggie, and I am a U-Media librarian at the Chicago Public Library. I'm going to do a quick embroidery tutorial for you today. I'm going to show you how to do this kawaii strawberry. I love to draw kawaii things. You can draw kawaii tacos, kawaii sushi, kawaii cactuses. All you need are usually a smiling face. If you want to add two little blushes, that's usually really cute. I'm going to show you how I did it from start to finish. It's a simple project. I just used back stitch and satin stitch, straight stitch, and I did two French notch, which are optional. And I have dyed the fabric with color pencils and water. It's a really simple, fun project if you're looking for something to do this summer. So let's get started. I drew this kawaii strawberry freehand using friction pens. Place the fabric you're going to embroider into an embroidery hoop and tighten it. The video is going to move a little slow for this portion. I just want you to get a really good idea of how the stitch works. You make your first stitch, just a simple straight stitch, up and down. And then you make your second stitch back into the first stitch. This is why it's called backstitch. I'm gonna demo this a few more times slowly just so you get the hang of it. Finishing up the red strawberry, as you can see, backstitch is a really simple outlining stitch. I'm going to use green thread and do backstitch again for the top of the strawberry. This will be the last sequence of backstitch, and we're going to use black thread to make the smile. Right now, I'm demonstrating straight stitch. I'm using straight stitch to make the seeds of the strawberries. I've chosen this coral thread. I thought it would make a pretty contrast against the bright red. Straight stitch is one of the easiest embroidery stitches, as you can see. It's just up and down, little tack marks. And I have them kind of sprinkled over the strawberry. Okay, so we're moving along. I'm going to demonstrate French knots, which this is an optional stitch you can use. I'm going to use French knots to make the blush. I'm using the same color thread as I use for the seeds. With French knots, it does take practice, so you may not want to try it on this project. You might want to try it on a scrap piece of fabric a few times first. But a French knot is made by coming up, and then you twist the thread around the needle, and then you put the needle back into the fabric, and you pull it, and it makes a knot. And you pull it slowly, because if you pull too fast, you can ruin the French knot and just have a tangle. We're gonna finish up with satin stitch. Satin stitch is a filler stitch. As you can see, I started in the center, I make a straight stitch, and then I make straight stitches to the left of it and then to the right of it to make the shape of the circle. And you'll do this for both eyes. Okay, so we have such a cute and happy strawberry. It's very kawaii. You can stop here. It looks very cute as is. You don't have to dye the fabric, but if you want to, I'm going to show you how to do that. Either way, you should iron away the pen marks if you used a friction pen or an erasable pen. And press the fabric. I'm using colored pencils and water to dye the fabric. You just dip the colored pencil in water and start to spread the color. And you'll keep dipping the colored pencil in water to get more watercolor out of it. It's similar to using watercolor pencils. I'm just using regular color pencils. I picked a red that was a little lighter than the red that outlines the strawberry. You'll notice it's going on dark. When you pick a color pencil, you'll want to remember that the color fades as it dries. Thank you for embroidering with us today. Please subscribe to our YouTube channel for more videos.